fresh, we got a brand new visor, yeah. You're friend smart, but my boy's wiser, yeah. Get the job done like the equalizer. And I'ma grab another drink, cause tonight I'm gonna die like Michael Phelps. Hey, diving in this pool.
Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte, North Carolina. It's the NFC Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports. Carolina Panthers taking on Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks.
And we welcome all of our viewers inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault, and that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the Carolina Panthers. Hello, everyone. As the postseason continues here on EA Sports, we're pleased to bring it to you. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And who has the edge here? You got one side that had some extra rest, but another comes in off a win last week in the wild card round.
And it's funny, depending on which team you are, you say that that's an advantage. You'll take the rest. You'll take the week off. Get your guys healed up a little bit and ready to go. But that team is coming in off of a win last week, they're really excited to keep playing. They feel like they are hot and ready to go.
Seattle's first go on offense forthcoming, and under center, of course, Russell Wilson.
And if he and his guys want to spring the upset here in the second round and move on, they've got to focus on the good that they did in the wild card victory. At the top of that list, protecting the football. Got a little careless last week. A few got away from him. Might not be so fortunate this time around. And if that's the case, they'll end up going home.
This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, there's nothing but room to run.
And he'll get this up only to about the 33. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
On third down, Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
This is taken at the 15. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. That's a 49-yard punt. 8, though, on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. So here are the Panthers under head coach Matt Rhule. They'll be taken out by the product of the University of Louisville, the talented Teddy Bridgewater.
And playoff games in and of themselves, we know they're pressure-filled. That's not breaking any news. But you have to wonder how much added pressure this team feels, given that a perfect season is on the line. They heard it during the regular season. Now they've sat at home for 2 weeks hearing about it. Can they handle that as well as the team that they're facing in order to try and advance?
Takes it to the 26, just a 1 yard gain. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
A gain of a yard. Brings up second and
Bridgewater to throw it. Trying to get it to Anderson, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
By the Seahawks.
So, CD, his very first pass of the afternoon intercepted.
And I know that's a major surprise for any quarterback because, look, let's face it, no one thinks about throwing interceptions. But think about all the warm-up that we saw, right? Every pass he threw wasn't a single interception because, oh, that's right, there were no defenders out there. A little bit different when there's live guys out there chasing the football.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. After the interception, here's Wilson. Forced out to his left. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and
now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. So that'll back him up five. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Here's Wilson. Flush to his right. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
And it's third down.
From the gun, it's Wilson. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback. But as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
Bridgewater and the Panthers going to come up here first and 10 right at the 30. Following the interception, here's Bridgewater. He's going to look deep for more. Now a clash of bodies here and it's intercepted. Picked up by Mikel Roby Coleman.
But to me it's pretty simple and it's fairly obvious, isn't it? He's got to start making better decisions with the ball.
That's now two interceptions in the first quarter. After interception number one, there was a long talk on the sideline. And now he's made another mistake.
Yeah, he's just been kind of laying these passes out there. He's kind of been floating them a little bit. He's got to be more decisive in his reads and definitely more decisive in throwing the ball. Rifle it in there every now and then.
Here's Russell Wilson and the Seahawk offense now getting set to go again. He has a big thank you to say to his defense. He threw the interception, then boom, the defense gets it back.
But the ebb and flow of a game is something else, isn't it? But you made an excellent point. A big thanks is owed to that defense. They went out there on what we call a sudden change after a turnover and didn't give up anything. In fact, took the ball away and set them up again. Really nicely done.
So a clean slate and a mulligan. To throw again on second down. Wilson. It's brought in here by Willie Snead. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
An 8 yard pickup. First down, Seattle.
They'll run on first down. It's Carson. And he stopped immediately there. Shaq Thompson on the tackle that time.
Second and 10. A very chilly day here, but no snow. And I gotta say, if it's gonna be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy.
And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
On third down,
Carson. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47.
On the carry.
Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
First down.
Here's Carson. He'll get three up to midfield.
Carson, again, the ball carrier.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3 yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
We're scoreless after one. This is Carson. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
A gain of 4. And it's third down.
Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Disley.
Wilson.
And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, and it's good for a first down as well. Wilson's throw caught by Metcalf. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. DK Metcalf, 37 yards, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it all culminates with a Seattle score. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded inside the 5. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
The Panthers take over first and 10.
Teddy Bridgewater and his Panthers ready to go again. He and his team, they have had a rough go of it here in this first half. Maybe time for him to put his foot down here in the second quarter.
Put his foot down and become a little more accurate throwing the football. He's already thrown 2 interceptions. He's trying to find a way to equal things out. And instead of it going to the opponents, get it to his own receivers and find the end zone.
Yeah, you mentioned those 2 picks. No touchdown passes yet either. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. McCaffrey on the counter. Room here to run. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Bridgewater, a play fake to McCaffrey. He'll look to throw. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. A good pickup there, a 22.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
A first down throw for Bridgewater. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
His throw caught right around the 6. The first red zone opportunity for the Panthers thus far. They've got a first and goal to go at the 7. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. DJ Moore there to make the grab. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. That time, 75-yard drive, 5 plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off.
Graham Gano to kick off for Carolina.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. They run it with Carson, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Earlier this half, you were wondering how the defense was going to handle him defensively. Were they going to bottle him up at different levels, so to speak, is what you said. What have you seen so far?
Well, I think they've been absolutely terrific because it feels like on every play, if we were watching this in the film room, when he clicked off the film or stopped it, you would see 11 shirts of that same color right there in the frame trying to tackle it. That's what you're looking for.
Third down.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. They'll run the screen with Carson, and he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. He gets seven out of it, and he also gets a first.
First down, Seattle.
From the shotgun, Wilson. And that's complete to Swain. That catch good for only a couple. So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
A gain of two. Brings up second and
operating from the gun. Wilson. That's complete into the hands of Carson. They'll get four out of that, and it'll bring up a third down. Wilson now to throw on third down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. The linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
And here's Dixon to punt now as he gets this one away. And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked out inside the 5 yard line.
4 yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5 yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Back near the goal line, Bridgewater. Eluding the pressure right. He'll run it. And they'll get him down right around the 11-yard line. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
It's a gain of seven. Brings up second.
Here's Bridgewater.
At the 11-yard line.
To the right side, and he's got more complete. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
He's going to look deep for more. It's caught inside the 25. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big play there just before halftime. 57 yards. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. In the final seconds of the first half, and the Panthers have taken the lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And he's got it up and through. So that drive, four plays. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown.
Seven. Graham Gano to kick off for Carolina.
So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. Taken from about the 12. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do.
In a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC Divisional Round matchup as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. This fourth and final matchup on this Divisional Round weekend. We'll get back to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's take a look back to Saturday's NFC Divisional Round game. But first, let's take a look back to yesterday's action. Meanwhile, in our game, we're set up for a terrific second half. So to find out who will advance to the NFC title game, let's send it back out to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway from the six. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
The Panthers take over first down.
Time to take a glance into what we've seen so far from Teddy Bridgewater. And they must have seen something leading up to this one that said, hey, we're going to be able to go deep because they've gone deep with a lot of success.
And pick your phrase, pick your code words, your buzzwords, whatever, vertical stretch, deep passes, go routes, right? What's that value you love? What's that value?
Four verts.
All of it working because they're able to find ways to get deep and for him to show off that big, big arm.
We see some of that big arm right here. He has been great. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The last run got six, now second and four. Again, they run again, it's McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
A gain of a yard brings up third and three.
Third and short yardage, Bridgewater. Open man is Robbie Anderson. Anderson loses the football, and the Seahawks have recovered.
Pass complete.
A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it. And not realizing the danger lurks while you're doing so. And there's your end result right there.
And this is one of those bang-bang plays, Charles. Did the knee hit first or did the ball come out first?
This is where you need that 20-20 eyesight, don't you, Brandon? You've got to see which one happened first. If the knee hit the ground, then they will keep possession.
At the line, ready to go. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
And try to atone for it here on this drive. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. There's Bridgewater. That'll be complete to Cook.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
He'll get about four here, down to the 43-yard line.
Number 22.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
Taken down at the 43-yard line.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. Trying to turn the corner, but they string him out and stop him at the line of scrimmage.
Take him down.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you.
And it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore. DJ Moore, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
And that's a drive that makes everyone happy on that bench because they accomplished exactly what they set out to do. Take care of the football, eat up a little clock, end up in the end zone. Now they've got a cushion for the rest of the game. So they didn't just help themselves offensively, they helped their defense out as well.
Gano for the extra point. And it's no good. No, he misses the extra point, and our score stays right where it is.
Graham Gano to kick off for Carolina.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss.
Taken from about the 12.
And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34.
At their own 34-yard.
Now we'll see what this Seahawks offense has in store with their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. But sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Now Wilson. And it's a quick slant to Lockett. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And he just falls short down at the one-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 69 yards. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. And that's why you have the fullback, Charles. Couldn't get it into play before with the smaller guy. Turn to a little more power. They score it.
And now it has to warm the hearts of a lot of old-school football fans. They love when they get to see a little bit of power football.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
There's DJ Moore as he and the rest of the offense head back out there. Seems like the measuring stick for a receiver for a great game is 100 yards. Well, he's well past that now.
And as we analyze how he's getting it, that's where it really becomes fun, because let's face it, they keep sending coverage at him, keep trying to put the pressure on, yet he finds ways downfield and finds openings. That's a really crafty receiver.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run. What a game it's been for this duo.
They remind me of a good comedy team. They know how to play off of each other so well. No matter how one riffs, the other's right there to pick them up, and they are shredding them in this ballgame.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Bridgewater going to give this to McCaffrey.
Christian McCaffrey.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
It was Trey Flowers that time who got a hand in and broke it up. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. Completes it to Samuel. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A first down and then some. Give him 29 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. First down, Bridgewater. This is caught, and he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. On the ground, McCaffrey, and he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out, and the Panthers add on to their lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that, and wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. And unable to connect, they don't get the two-point conversion here.
And the two-point conversion is no good.
Popular down near the goal line, quick slant. Nice job there to get in, knock it away.
It was. One of the other things you're concerned about when you throw that route is to make sure your offensive linemen use their leverage to get the hands of the defensive front down so you can throw it through that little bit of crowd and get it to the receiver. In this event, they did, but a nice play by the defender knocking it away.
Fields this way up at the 17. Lane opens here. He's past the 30.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. And they need to come up with something as they get this drive started. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make it second down. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool them and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson, left side complete to Lockett. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
Seahawks.
From midfield now, here's Wilson. Brought in left side by Sneed. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. And chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. To throw again is Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. Now second and 11 from the 32. Again, Wilson. And incomplete. Freddie Swaim was the intended receiver. And that'll make it third down.
Third down and 11.
Throwing again here, Wilson.
Wilson.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And his bid for the first down coming up short as he's tackled at the 25. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. And that is incomplete. The Seahawks go for it but can't convert. And the Panthers will get the football back. So still over 3 minutes remaining in this game. But, boy, not getting that one, that hurt.
That's a little bit demoralizing, so they have to be careful about that because still have an opportunity if they can get some things done on defense. But now, since they've taken over on downs, a team with the ball, guess what? Going to four-minute offense, maybe they can put this thing away.
Bridgewater going to lead the Panthers up here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. And he'll start by handing this off to McCaffrey. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Taken down by Bobby Wagner. It's a pickup of three.
They'll try and burn some clock now with McCaffrey. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
Christian McCaffrey.
They're going to hurry back to the line now.
He was taken down by Bobby Wagner. A 1-yard gain brings up third and six.
They go play action. Bridgewater. Escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. And he finds Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You stop to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and 2.
At the 40-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's McCaffrey. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he's going to get it all the way down to the 10-yard line. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Bridgewater here to throw. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. DJ Moore saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Buyer beware. Bridgewater. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So they elect to pass there on the two-point try. Sometimes could prove risky there. It worked out.
Yeah, and I love how you bring up that it can prove risky because if you get it intercepted and they return it, that's 2 points for the defense, but not on that play.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fields this way up at the 17. Now a crease here as he's past the 30.
Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field.
They knew this would be tough on the road, divisional round, and that has certainly been the case with the deficit they face in this fourth quarter.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. They'll run the screen with Carson. A good pickup there on first as a screen pass gets him eight. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Jeremy Chinn in there to bury him for a loss of 11. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. 30, 20, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Seahawks are able to close the gap just a bit.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. DJ Moore. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
Well, they certainly have the look of a team with something to prove, don't they? All week, as we prepared for this game, we kept reading about how they said they're going to play a full 60 minutes this week. Has nothing to do with their opponent. No disrespect intended, but they wanted to be people of their word, playing this thing all the way out, trying to finish it strong.
And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. From the gun, Bridgewater. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. And the formula there on the two-point try to go five wide. Not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run ahead of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
First and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
See how they handle the waning moments of this one. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. From the gun, it's Wilson. Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
The Panthers' season will press on as we say so long, everybody.
So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out.